let me welcome you again. Thank you for your interest in wildlife. Let's explore more. The blue-spotted ribbontail ray is a species of stingray in the family Dasyatidae. Found from the intertidal zone to a depth of 30 meters, this species is common throughout the tropical Indian and western Pacific Oceans in nearshore, coral reef-associated habitats. It is a fairly small ray, with a mostly smooth, oval pectoral fin disc, large protruding eyes, and a relatively short and thick tail with a deep fin fold underneath. It can be easily identified by its striking color pattern of many electric blue spots on a yellowish background, with a pair of blue stripes on the tail. At night, small groups follow the rising tide onto sandy flats to root for small benthic invertebrates and bony fishes in the sediment. When the tide recedes, the rays separate and withdraw to shelters on the reef. Reproduction is aplacental viviparous, with females giving birth to litters of up to 7 young. This ray is capable of injuring humans with its venomous tail spines, though it prefers to flee if threatened. Because of its beauty and size, the blue-spotted ribbontail ray is popular with private aquarists despite being poorly suited to captivity. The pectoral fin disc of the blue-spotted ribbontail ray is oval in shape, around 4/5 as wide as long, with a rounded to broadly angular snout. The large, protruding eyes are immediately followed by the broad spiracles. There is a narrow flap of skin between the nares with a fringed posterior margin, reaching past the mouth. The lower jaw dips at the middle and deep furrows are present at the mouth corners. The pelvic fins are narrow and angular. The thick, depressed tail measures about 1.5 times the disc length and bears one or two serrated spines well behind the tail base. There is a deep fin fold on the ventral surface, reaching the tip of the tail, and a low midline ridge on the upper surface. The skin is generally smooth, save for perhaps a scattering of small thorns on the middle of the back. The dorsal coloration is striking, consisting of numerous circular, neon blue spots on a yellowish brown or green background. The spots vary in size, becoming smaller and denser towards the disc margin. The tail has two stripes of the same blue running along each side as far as the spines. The eyes are bright yellow and the belly is white. Individuals found off southern Africa may lack the blue tail stripes. It ray hides amongst coral during the day. One of the most abundant stingrays inhabiting Indo-Pacific reefs, it generally spends the day hidden alone inside caves or under coral ledges or other debris, often with only its tail showing. At night, small groups assemble and swim onto shallow sandy flats with the rising tide to feed. Unlike many other stingrays, this species seldom buries itself in sand. It excavates sand pits in search of mollusks, polychaete worms, shrimps, crabs, and small benthic bony fishes. When prey is located, it is trapped by the body of the ray and maneuvered into the mouth with the disc. Other fishes, such as goatfish, frequently follow foraging rays, seeking food missed by the ray. Breeding occurs from late spring to summer. Like other stingrays, this species is aplacental viviparous. The embryos are initially sustained by yolk, which later in development is supplemented by histotroph produced by the mother. The gestation period is thought to be between 4 and 12 months long. Females bear litters of up to 7 young. Known predators include hammerhead sharks and bottlenose dolphins. It is also potentially preyed upon by other large fishes and marine mammals. When threatened, this ray tends to flee at high speed in a zigzag pattern to throw off pursuers. Numerous parasites have been identified from this species. This ray has been observed soliciting cleanings from the blue streak cleaner wrasse by raising the margins of its disc and pelvic fins. I am grateful for your visit. We will meet again pretty soon. Bye for now, take care of your family. Let's protect our wildlife.